Despite mounting concern and extraordinary measures taken in China to protect the public, the World Health Organization on Thursday said it was too early to consider an international outbreak of a new virus to be a global emergency.
I'm not declaring a public health emergency of international concern today. As it was yesterday, the emergency committee was divided over whether the outbreak of novel coronavirus represents a PHEIC or not. Make no mistake, this is, though, an emergency in China. But it has not yet become a global health emergency. It may yet become one. WHO's risk assessment is that the outbreak is very high risk in China and a high risk regionally and globally. 584 cases have now been reported to WHO, including 17 deaths. 575 of those cases and all of the deaths have been reported in China, with other cases reported in Japan, the Republic of Korea, Singapore, Thailand, the United States of America, and Vietnam. It's likely that we will see more cases in other parts of China and other countries. China has taken measures it believes appropriate to contain the spread of coronavirus in Wuhan and other cities. We hope that they will be both effective and short in their duration. For the moment, WHO does not recommend any broader restrictions on travel or trade.
With regard to case fatality, it's something that's come up again and again in epidemics. We have to be very, very careful at the beginning of an epidemic in making any pronouncements around the true severity of an epidemic. Because it can work both ways. At the moment, we haven't seen many mild cases. As we detect more mild cases, then effectively the severity may decrease because there are more mild cases in proportion to severe cases, and that may do it. We also need to be careful in that many people are very sick in hospital right now, and more may die in the coming days, and the number of deaths may increase. And that may give the impression of an increased severity. So it's extremely important that we stick to the facts.
Most public transport in the city of Wuhan, population 11 million, was suspended on Thursday and people were told not to leave. Video obtained by Reuters show empty market stalls where people have been panic buying and rushing to stock up on supplies. One Wuhan resident, originally from South Africa, shot this video from the city's airport while trying to leave the city.
Most of the railway stations are actually closed, so people coming to the airport will have to make alternative arrangements. So it's difficult to travel around today due to the virus. And people are actually advised to stay at home and also not to mingle with the crowds.
Later on Thursday, neighboring Huanggang, a city of 7 million people, announced a similar lockdown. Chinese health authorities say the newly identified coronavirus strain has infected hundreds and killed more than a dozen people. Patients have been identified in South Korea, Japan, and the United States. Airports across the globe have started screening travelers. While the WHO adopts a wait-and-see approach to the outbreak, health officials speaking in the World Economic Forum in Switzerland cautioned that while the illness appears to be less fatal than the recent SARS virus, it could be more contagious.
10% of people died in SARS. I suspect the mortality rate with this infection will be lower than that as it spreads to a much wider population. So what we have is a broader infection with probably a less marked number of people, percentage of people dying. But that is in some ways from a public health perspective is harder to deal with.
American health officials said work on a vaccine was underway, but the treatment would not likely be ready for some time.